Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and today's video is a correction. So, a couple of weeks ago, I did a video on a Confederate Whitworth rifle, and one of the things that I pointed out in that video was the extreme accuracy of the Whitworth at the time. Now, the Whitworth was an extremely accurate rifle for its time. However, it wasn't quite as accurate as I said it was. So, I had a number of people, three in particular, point this out to me after that video published. Those people being John Simpson, who is the author of a couple of books on sniping, David Minshall, who runs a website called Research Press in the UK on long-range shooting, and Rob from the YouTube channel British Muzzleloaders. Now, these guys all were telling me the same thing, and that is what I read off as what I identified as minute of angle groups, as in like the size of an entire group on paper, for the Whitworth rifle were in fact not measurements of group size, but measurements of something called figure of merit. And figure of merit is how the British military measured its rifle accuracy at this time period. And this, the trial that I was referencing here, took place in 1857. Now, to make things a little bit more complicated, there is an American term, figure of merit, and there's also a British term for figure of merit. Now, in American parlance, figure of merit means taking the extreme horizontal spread and the extreme vertical spread of a group and averaging them. But we're not even going to bother talking about that because that has nothing to do with our story about the Whitworth. The British version of figure of merit is what we would call mean radius or mean radial dispersion. And what that means is you fire a group, and in this case, the British standardized on a 20-shot group. You then mathematically find the center point of the group. Then you measure the distance from that center point to each individual bullet hole. You add all of those up and you average them. And the average of the distance from the center of the group to the bullet hits is your figure of merit in British terminology. Now, what this does is actually give you a very valuable measure of how well a rifle shoots, because it's going to assess the overall size of the group, or rather the consistency of the group. If you have an extremely tight group with one weird flyer, measuring it in this way minimizes the impact of that flyer in a way that simply measuring group size doesn't. So, for example, if we had 20 shots, and let's say 19 of them are in a one-inch circle, right smack in the middle, and you've got one flyer way out here a foot away, that's, let's call it a 12-inch group. If you have 10 flyers all about 12 inches away, you still have a 12-inch group. However, we know that a group with 19 shots in a circle and one flyer is better than one with this random dispersion of 20 shots through a 12-inch group. And the British figure of merit terminology does a much better job of assessing that sort of quality, comparative quality. So, at any rate, this is how the British were measuring accuracy. And in this rifle trial, for example, at 500 yards, and by the way, this is yards, because the British at this time were still using yards, The Whitworth rifle had a figure of merit of 0.37 feet, which is about 4.5 inches. So what that tells us is that the average distance from the center point of the group, not the aiming point, but the center point of where all the shots hit, the average distance from the center to each shot was about 4.5 inches. Now, I wanted to try and figure out how to convert this into something like minute of angle, you know, total group size, to give you guys and myself for that matter, a way of understanding this group that makes sense to what we're used to. So Mr. Simpson, John Simpson, thoughtfully was able to provide me the mathematical numbers to do that. In order to go from figure of merit to group size, you basically are doing sort of statistical analysis. You can never tell the actual size of the original group from a figure of merit number, but you can tell statistically what it probably was. And so with a 20-shot group, we're going to multiply our figure of merit by 3.643. And that will give us, statistically, the overall size of the group. We're then, of course, going to divide by 5.235, which will convert a group size in inches at 500 yards to a minute of angle measurement. And using this, what we actually see for the Whitworth's accuracy at 500 yards is 3.1 minute of angle. That is still a really remarkably, impressively accurate rifle for 1857. It shouldn't be downplayed. Obviously, I should have done my own due diligence better. I should have realized that a sub-minute of angle muzzleloader really doesn't quite pass the smell test. but I didn't, and that's on me, certainly. So what we actually have with the Whitworth at 500 is 3.1 minute of angle. For sake of comparison, if we do the same conversion to the Enfield musket, which was the British military long arm of the time, and it's what the Whitworth was being compared against, the Enfield had a figure of merit of 2.24 feet at 500 yards, which comes out to 18.7 minute of angle. So the group fired by the Whitworth was something like 1/6 the size of the group fired by the Enfield. This should put into perspective just how much more accurate the Whitworth was than its competitors. And unfortunately, I think people may downplay how impressive that number is because I said originally in the first video that it was, in fact, something much better than that. If we go all the way out, the longest range that they actually continued to fire the Enfield at was 1,100 yards. Beyond that, the Enfield simply wasn't making hits on target, and they couldn't do a 20-shot group. At 1,100, the Whitworth was still making 20-minute of angle to the Enfield's 61-minute of angle. Now, keep in mind, at 1,100 yards, we are well past the distance at which both of these rifles went from supersonic, or both the projectiles from both rifles, went from supersonic to subsonic. And when that happens, accuracy tends to degrade as the bullet passes through its own sonic boom and tends to destabilize. So 20 minute of angle doesn't sound very good. But I tell you what, at 1,100 yards, that is certainly no mean feat, especially for a muzzleloader in 1857. So anyway, this has just been a short video to issue a formal correction. I think it's the first time I've had to do that, and I will be more careful in the future and try to avoid ever having to do one of these again. But hopefully, besides just making a correction, we learned something new today about how accuracy has been measured in different times and places. Thanks very much for watching, and we'll be back tomorrow with another interesting forgotten weapon.